Hello guys, and welcome to the Arsenal Rebuild, where we've got a decent team to work with. Leno, Tierney, Gabriel, Luiz, Bellerin, Pepe, Partey, Torreira, Saka, Odegaard, Aubameyang, as well as this as a bench. So we've got a decent set of players with this much money. And the only thing we have done is brought back Torreira back and signed Ben White, but they're the only two major things. So, my first signing. Well, first of all, I want to see what I think I'm going to try and sign Ederson. So we're going to cut to that. Right now. There. We've already offered this and we're delegating his wage, so that's good. So Ederson's coming in. So we've got to think what we could use two defenders and a right back. So an easy one I think of is a cheaper one, and it's Sergio Ramos. 30 million for an 89 rated is really good. So we do go into contract negotiations with Real Madrid for Sergio Ramos, and I'm hoping he will improve the back line. 35 million for him. He will start depleting in overall, but for a season this big, Ramos and Ederson in a back line is good. I don't think I need a new left back, because Tierney's 80 rated, that's fine for a left back. But I could use a better right back and a better centre back, which is why we are going in for Ramos. And I could use another centre back. So why not go for another Real Madrid centre back. So I'm going to try and get Eder Militao, because I think he's really good. He's not that high rated, but he's quite decent. So we can go back to Zinedine Zidane to offer for Eder Militao. And I think 35 million again for him is going to be a lot better. Now I'm hoping that this one, that 40 million for him, let's offer that. See what they say. I think this is going to be a lot better than the last one, because we've got more money and we're using it more wisely than rather using 200 million in Mbappe. So we have to just add an extra bit for Eder Militao, which is fine. Now the only thing we have done is, because a bit of my recording cut out, so we signed Ben White, recalled Torreira, and started with our Ederson. So that's all you've missed. My thing started to not really work, so we're gonna go from 160k to 360k, that's fair. So we're gonna hopefully try and get them in. We're gonna try and skip a couple of days to hopefully try and get them, just to the 4th of July. And they have all accepted. Ooh. I don't really care, David Luiz. Militao has accepted. And Ederson has accepted, so we do bring them two in. Right. And we've got received an offer for Rob Holding and Aubameyang. But one rule is we're not allowed to sell anyone in these. We have to keep the players, and we've also got to sell the players, so. But we're not allowed to sell anyone, that's what I meant. So we can stick Leno on the bench now, because we've got a much better choice for Nets. As well, we now also have Eder Militao to go on the left, and hopefully Ramos on the right. So we'll try and get Ramos in, and he has accepted, which is good. So now we've got a better back line. We can just stick David Luiz on the bench, and then stick Ramos on the team. So Ramos is there. We could use a right back, a better right winger, a midfield, maybe a striker. So there's a couple of positions we need to improve. And I think the first one is, I think I want to get all the defence out, because that defence is looking good, but it's the right back, isn't it? So I think I'm going to go with João Cancelo. I think that's who we're going to try and go in for. So we're going to go begin negotiations with the club, and we're going to try and get for 66 million. So we're going for quite a similar signing pattern with two Man City players and two Real Madrid players. But I promise there will be more clubs players that we're going to be signing. So 66 million for João Cancelo. Decent, because that's like plus 11, that's like what he's worth, plus 11 million. So they want him for 97 million. It's a bit much. We might be able to move that down to 80 million, and then we keep 17 million extra to spend, because I've got a really cool player I'm looking to hopefully sign. So when I try and take that down to 80 million, that's what we're going to try and do. Take that down to 80 million. Man City do now do not have much of a chance without Ederson. So Man City, I think, we've not got to worry about them this season. Not sure, I'll just accept this for João Cancelo, as he's decent. He's younger, so it means he's got a little bit of room for improvement, which that is good. We're just gonna delegate his wages. And so far, this is a decent window for players we have signed. Now, here's another player I'd have to have a look out for. Because, if you didn't know, when Arsene Wenger was still the manager, he tried to sign Luis Suarez from Liverpool. So we are going to get Luis Suarez from Atletico. Honestly, we'll just pay that. Wait for them to come in, and then just spend the rest of our money on slightly lower rated players. Just gonna skip a wee bit. Now, we have put Arsenal into the final of the Champions League. So the thing is, again, if we make it to the final of the Champions League, we will be playing that. And I think this time we might be playing João Cancelo and Luis Suarez in our end, which is really good. 100 million left. And I think what I'm going to do is change the formation to have two strikers and fullbacks as well. And four at the back as well. So I think I've got to go with this. So we can play Tierney there, right? Militao. We'll have David Luiz, Ramos, Tierney. We'll have Aubameyang and Suarez. It's a decent back line. So now all we really need is maybe two better midfielders. That would be the only other thing we'd need, honestly. And I think I could just chuck in, it's like centre mids, isn't it? So Ceballos fits in nicely, and I think and Thomas Partey would also fit in, so that actually works out. So now I'm gonna have Ben White and Cedric on the bench, and Xhaka, and then we'll have Nketiah. So I think it's just a midfielder we really need, and then we've got a decent team. We could use a right centre mid, and I think I want to go a bit more expensive. So could we go for Federico Valverde? for another Real Madrid player. He's 52 million. We could maybe get him for 80 million, and then that would be virtually our entire transfer window. I mean, with this team, I think we're expected to go to the Champions League finals. We're going to offer 65 million. Hopefully they accept, because then we've got 40 million left for maybe a bunch of lower rated players from the bench. We could add more lower rated players for the bench. Getting Valverde would probably improve the squad a lot. So Zinedine Zidane straight up accepts it, which is good, because that means we've practically got him. So we'll just offer for that. And FIFA videos get copyrighted, like, massively for me, because there's no way to get rid of the music. So please try and watch this video as much as you can. For FIFA 22, I'm going to try and get rid of the music as much as I can. So I'm just going to skip a couple more days. Hopefully get him in, and then we can just work on signing a couple of bench players. He does accept, and that is basically all of our, that's a good chunk of signings. With 32 million left, it's a lot better. So we can stick Sebos on the bench instead of Elneny. So that's a decent team. Ederson, Militao, Ramos, David Luiz, Cancelo, Tierney, Thomas Partey, Valverde, Odegaard, Suarez, and Aubameyang. It's really good. Now what I'm going to do is I think I'll try and sign Thiago Silva, because he's really cheap. And I mean really cheap. So having him as well, he's 85 rated. That's a slight improvement to David Luiz, who's 79 rated. So we will try and get this man in. And then I think we're just going to try and skip the end of the season and hopefully play the Champions League final. We're just going to offer, how much is worth? 13 million. We're just going to offer that. They want Rob Holding and 8 million. Honestly, fine. Because I don't think Rob Holden's going to get any game time. So they can take Rob Holden. We get Thiago Silva. And then that leaves us 26 million to spend on other players. Which means we've got a bit more money to sign on. We have reached maximum squad size. So I think I'm just going to go release some of the lower rated players. So we're just going to release Cottrell, release Heen, and release, we can only release two. Alright, so that's two players released then. So that means we can only sign, what, one more player? So we'll try and sign a bigger player. So I'm going to keep skipping this. Try and get them to accept for Thiago Silva. What do they do? And Thiago Silva is now in. I think, honestly, that's all we're going to do. What a team we've built. I think we should make it to the Champions League final. So with that, honestly, let's just sim the end of May. And if we do make it to the Champions League final, I will try and commentate all of these games that we're hopefully winning. I will try and commentate them. So 5-4 against Liverpool in the Community Shield, that's good. We lose to Leicester, oh, that's not good. So that means we're already down in the Premier League. It should be a win. Another loss to Tottenham. How? Another loss. We've lost 3 games in a row. Like, we used to feel... How? How are we losing to Fulham? So we can beat Liverpool, but we can't beat Fulham. We have won no games in the league. We are currently bottom of the league. We beat Everton, so that's 3 points. We lose to Leicester in the cup, draw to Chelsea, and I don't know if we lost or won there to Ajax. A win to Crystal Palace. Come on, try and get some more wins. Wolves, Atalanta, Newcastle and Aston Villa. All of these should be wins. A draw with Wolves. Come on. Yes, we should be beating Atalanta, and we do. We beat Aston Villa, and we beat Newcastle. I guess it depends who the CPU is playing. But I mean, they should be playing our team, our players designed. Come on, we beat West Ham, right? We draw to Man City, we do. Beat Mitchelland and beat West Brom. That's what should... Draw with Mitchelland. Are we even going to get out of this group? I don't know now. December. And we beat Ajax. So are we through to the next round of the Champions League? I'm not sure, but we should beat Sheffield United, Leeds and Burnley, and Sheffield United again. December should be a winning month. Come on, try and win every game this month. We lose to Leeds. How does that happen? How does that happen? We should win in the cup game. Yeah, 1-0. We should beat West Ham. We should beat Newcastle. We should beat Brighton. And we should beat Southampton. Draw with West Ham. But we've got Luis. What? We've got Ederson in goal. Is it because we signed a bunch of older players in the back line? Are they depleting? Are they depleting on overall? That might be why we're losing. This video is doing so well. We are PSG in the Champions League in February. Come on. We might beat PSG here. It's a draw. Alright. It's a draw with PSG. We need to beat PSG to go through to the next round. Come on. Draw to Liverpool. We lose to PSG. No. That's us out of the Champions League now. I've accidentally pressed. So, this video is looking good. But we are out of the Champions League. That isn't great for Arsenal here. Oh, we beat Crystal Palace. That's a huge thank you to the team. Let's go. We beat Man City as well in the league. I'm hoping to win the Premier League because last time I think we finished 8th with Birmingham. I think that is what happened. I think we finished 8th. Beat Wolves. We should beat Spurs here. We should beat Spurs here. We did beat Spurs, actually. We beat Spurs again 2 times in a month and beat West Brom. That's an entire win. So we also got, I think that's a cup final. I think that is a final we are playing in May. Have we won the Premier League, though? That's the thing. So I want to see what this cup is. I want to see what it is. It is the final of the FA Cup. The team. Thiago Silva down to 86. Ederson's up. Militao's up. All of our players are. Oh, they've recalled. We've had to play Smith Rowe at CAM. But I mean, like, look at this attack. Oh, Suarez has went down in overall and Aubameyang's went up. But I mean, the defence is looking good. But I mean, Ramos and Silva have went down. I can see why we've lost a lot of games. So we'll review the season after this cup. So we're just going to go to it. And really care about any of this stuff. It's one season, we don't care about the youth academy. So we are just going to quick sim. So they've got De Gea, Pelez, Kimpembe, Maguire, Wan-Bissaka, Mora, McTominay, Fred, Rashford, Fernandes, and Cavani. We should win this. Quick sim it. And we lose in the final of the FA Cup. Unlucky. We didn't have that many good bench players. Honestly, we did do too well. How did we do in the trophies? Let's go to the... We placed fourth in the Premier League. That's a lot better from in the actual league being where Sheffield United are in this. That's a lot better. Fourth. In Community Shield, we won that against Liverpool. That's good. FA Cup, as you know, Man United have beat us. But we did do well in it. Carabao Cup. We lost that. Where did we go out in this? We went... wait, did we go out in round four? No. We go out in round four. We went out to Leicester 1-0 in round three. That is not good. Super Cup, we weren't even in that. Champions League, I think it was Bayern Munich Real. When did we go out? Was it the round of 16? Yeah, we went out in the round of 16. 1-0 to PSG. But we placed second in our group. Who won the Europa League? Or who's in the final? Liverpool and Real Sociedad. What was the group stages like? Oh, Celtic done well. Oh, they went out in quarterfinals. Well, who got the most goals, right? That's what I want to look at. So, appearances was Ederson. Ederson did very well. And Ramos was the captain. Who got the most goals? Aubameyang got 24 goals. Suarez got 19 goals. Lacazette got 11. Smith Rowe got 10. And Partey got 6. It's the top 5 goals. And someone we loaned out has got 5 goals for West Brom. So they've done well as well. So that's our top 5 goals. The team is alright. I'd say this is an L of the season. We could have done a lot better, but we probably would have bought more players, but we're at max squad size, and we bought a lot of older players. Fourth in the Premier League isn't bad. We were very close to the top, and if we did one more season, we would be in the Champions League, but we're not. Thank you guys for watching. I've been Gorilla Gaming. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.